All right, everyone, let us begin with the session for today. Now, before I start, I just wanted to clarify one thing. We have already conducted over 5 webinars in the past. This one is diving a little deeper into the concept of the LMS and the whole LMS universe. This one is mostly focused around the LMS, its different constituents, how their pricing is determined, and how tweaking them will affect your LMS and its pricing. Before we move ahead, I just want to give a quick introduction about myself. My name is Percy Bengali, and I'm working as a consultant with a senior consultant with Abara LMS. My specialty lies in problem solving, matching clients' needs with Abara's features, marketing, and creating the content that helps spread the news about Abara as a powerful LMS platform. Of lately, I'm also involved with making prospective LMS users rely on traditional training, understand of the LMS, and make the switch to something like an LMS in the oncoming periods. A quick info about our organization. At Abara LMS, we have a very rich heritage and strong belief in promoting training and development as the key, or sometimes as a unique solution to a corporate's problems. Abara LMS is a learning management system designed and built to train a corporate workforce in a way that training and development activities become an organization-wide activity. Our rich heritage and culture comes from our parent company, which is Enyota Learning, and we have been catering exclusively to the international market with custom e-learning courses, e-learning technology, and much more for the last 12 plus years now. Also, Abara LMS is an award-winning system which has been recognized by multiple third-party experts that we have absolutely no ties with, so rest assured these are not influenced awards in any ways. Which obviously just proves again that Abara is a system unlike any other. We put a lot of thought and design into developing our product. With that, let us quickly jump into the topic for the day, and that is, why are we hosting this webinar? Now, the thing is, we have come across a lot of prospective clients asking us, why does an LMS cost as much as it does? So we thought this webinar was a good way to break down the costs of what it takes to license an LMS. However, keep in mind that not all LMSs are priced the same. Now, there's one thing to remember. Some LMSs are rather complicated, and we believe that it is just a very smart way for vendors to increase their pricing in such a manner by making their LMS slightly complicated. Rest assured, we have simplified it as much as possible for everybody attending today's webinar. And one thing again to remember is that in most cases, an LMS should not cost or be priced in any other way. The only exception being you're looking at a really advanced LMS with multiple features that allow additional training capabilities. But once again, something to remember over here is that, in all honesty, most organizations do not need such complicated LMSs with high-end features. However, there is this one other reason which trumps the reason for today's webinar, and that is people should know in general about what an LMS comprises of, how the costing is implemented, and finally, how all of these components fit together, resulting in the prices that a vendor offers you. Now, you may wonder why. It's simply for two reasons. One is ROI and the second is awareness. Also, as a good practice, the awareness part comes in here. It is usually good to know what are the elements that comprise of your costing. This way, when you're present in the market and you're looking for an LMS platform, you can actually ask the vendor that you're looking at to provide you with the costing breakdown of the LMS they are providing you. And then you can verify for yourself if you're unknowingly paying for something extra, if you're paying for something that you really do not need, or if you're simply being overcharged. With that, we'll take a quick overview of what are the components that constitute the pricing of an LMS. So first, we have the setup cost. So every LMS, when you start off with, it comprises of first thing is called as the setup cost. Then you've got a licensing fee, which is based on two types, either an active user's license or a registered user's license. The third one is the hosting fee costs. And finally, you've got additional costs, which have a whole range of subsets to themselves. So we shall come across that eventually. For now, let us just say that we're going to talk about four distinct parts that make up the costing of your LMS. And you might ask, why are these factors important? Now, that is very straightforward and it is really simple. One, somewhere or the other, these parts affect the practicality of your LMS. Two, somewhere or the other, they also affect the need in all your LMS. They affect your functionality, the usage, and also your security. That is why these four elements are important to have an idea about. So before we move ahead, I want to take a quick poll. So the question should be popping up on your screen right now. This will help us understand better about how our audience is feeling today and what are their general outlook when considering an LMS. So just have a look at your screen right now. The poll should be on your screen. I'll give you all a few moments to fill it out. Take your time, read through the options. So basically, these are the kind of LMSs you usually find in the market, which is why we've put on this small poll to understand better what do y'all think about an LMS when y'all enter the market to make a purchasing decision. What is your outlook on it? All right. So I'm assuming everyone has taken the time to give their thought. And with that, I should be able to better understand how to cater to your needs today. All right. So that being said, let us quickly jump into the first part of your LMS's costing, and that is called as your setup costs. Now, what are setup costs? Setup costs are a one-time cost that most vendors charge when they set up your LMS for the first time. Now, you need to understand, because when you receive your new LMS, there are a checklist of do's and don'ts that need to be taken care of before the LMS can start functioning smoothly. Now, it's something like you installing a new software. You need to follow certain steps to ensure that your software is working. But as you may have guessed, the reason why a setup cost is always involved as a part of your pricing is because it takes a certain amount of technical knowledge to execute. Also, the LMS, when you first receive, it actually comes as a blank canvas. So an initial setup allows your administrator to straight dive into the training without spending too long on the technicalities of setting up, because it has a lot of settings and buttons to take care of. You could call it configurations. It is something that the vendor takes care of for you, which is why it is something that we charge initially. So what are these activities or services for which you're being charged under setup costs? Now, the first thing is it's called setting up your instance. Now, an instance, for those who may not be aware, is a certain amount of virtual space that is allowed to you where your LMS resides for people to access globally. Second is to create your portal. Now, the portal is your login page, which usually carries your organization's color, branding, and videos. Now, what you see on screen is a mock portal that I've created. This can be exchanged with a video, it can be exchanged with your branding, images, whatever you'd feel. Then you've got branding. Obviously, it is the placement of your logos, taglines throughout all sections of your LMS. Then we've got something called as an SSL certification installation. Now, this certificate ensures that your LMS is secure, especially if you're using the LMS to sell courses. But either ways, it is very important to have this as a security purposes. Then you've got something called as pointing the IP address. Now, your LMS initially starts off as an IP address, which eventually gets remapped to a domain name of your choice. So this again is a part of the setup costs. Finally, you got theming. So we have realized that when we give an LMS to somebody, one thing that we have realized is that making sure that the right color schemes are used, the right fonts being used, and the right button choices being used highly affects how learners accept your LMS and how administrators use their LMS, which is why theming is very important. Then you got white labeling. Now, white labeling is a process where we as a vendor ensure that our logo is not present anywhere. It just carries your organization's logo, which actually makes your LMS look like a custom built LMS for your organization. And finally, there are a whole list of other allied technicalities that come under one-time setup costs. Now, along with what I mentioned before, there are also a certain number of other additional things or allied costs that come under setup costs. And what are they? We call them dedicated training costs. Now, what are they? Your administrator requires training in order to operate the LMS. Now, that is taken care of by the vendor, which is why it comes under setup costs. It's a proper dedicated training that has been that is being given to your administrator to make sure they operate your LMS in a proper way, efficiently. Secondly is training that is provided to learners in order for them to focus more on the learning aspect of the LMS and less on the figuring out how the LMS works part of the LMS. Finally, you've got the line managers who are your team managers who handle their own subset teams. So there is also a small section where they can handle the training for their team members of maybe 5 or 10 people, however, how many ever people they have. And then you've got instructors. Now, some organizations have in-house instructors. Some of you are in-house instructors who are attending today. So there's a training that is provided to you guys by us. And that is also taken care under here. Now, one thing to note over here is that at Abara, we charge a one-time setup cost. However, you will realize that our one-time setup costs are quite nominal. All right. So, how are you charged to setup? One thing to note over here is that the charging, the setup cost for LMS providers can vary anywhere from between $2,000 to the higher end of $10,000. For implementation, configuration, and the training workshops. We have already covered these points. At Abara, we charge a very nominal amount of setting up, which is $2,000. And why is our amount so nominal? Just for one reason. Companies that charge $10,000, and you will realize that many are actually charging close to this figure or somewhere alongside it, maybe late thousands, are usually companies that have a very complicated LMS. Which is why they require to avail their services to help with the setup of users, configuration of roles, permissions, department roles, locations, etc., and a whole lot of things. Even after the initial setup with these organizations, you will realize that sometimes even more rounds of back and forths are required, which is why these organizations charge these absurdly high amounts, which range close to $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000, and even $10,000. However, Abara LMS was specifically designed with an award-winning UI and UX, which makes training your admin and learners an easy task. On using Abara, you yourself will realize that multiple rounds of trainings are certainly not needed in most cases. Hence, we knew that, you know, charging something so on the higher end, like, you know, more than 5,000, 6,000, somewhere around that range, absolutely made no sense. And as you can also see on screen, we have won multiple awards by all of these third-party experts, which just proves that we mean business when it comes to, you know, giving the best at the best cost. So that forms your first costing, and that is the setup cost. Whatever I mentioned under this was a part of the setup cost. With that, we come to part two that forms your LMS's pricing, and that is active users cost. And now this is where it becomes important for most people over here who already have an LMS, because usually your yearly billing cycle totally depends on this, on the number of active users you pay for on a yearly basis. All right. So you might have to like pay a little close attention to this because it could get a little complicated with the calculations coming up, but I'll try to make it as simple as possible. First, let us start with understanding what are active users. Active users are the number of people that are allowed to access your LMS during a given month. Now, this may get confusing, so I'm asking you all to please lend me your good ear. I'm going to give you all an example. Say that I have an organization and I have 500 people, and I'm sure that during any given month, out of those 500 people, only 100 people are going to use the LMS. So in that case, it absolutely makes no sense for me to purchase licenses for all 500 people. So what do I do? I have an option where I can actually register or make the accounts for of all 500 people on the back end of my LMS, but I will make sure that only up to 100 people out of those 500 can access my LMS in any given month for their training needs. Now, once again, I'd like to reiterate, I have 500 employees, but I will register and I will register all 500 of them, but I will buy a plan where only any 100 out of them can access the LMS in a given month. That is called as your active user plan. And frankly speaking, that is the first part of almost all LMS's pricing. It is made up of the cost associated with these individual learners or these plans. That is the first part. It is a recurring cost. It comes to all LMS users and people who actually have licensed their LMS right now. So how is the pricing determined based on the number of active users? Now, this is and always should be very simple. Every individual user's account or an active account has a certain cost associated with it. Now, the prices for these can vary from anywhere in between rupees 150 per user to rupees 300 per user. So basically, based on your vendor's pricing policy, you pay rupees 150 or rupees 300 for each user. And what are the factors that justify this price? Factors that justify this price are very simple. There is a certain amount of storage space which is given to each individual learners where their progress is recorded. There is also a separate section where reports are created for individual learners. Push notification features are being given for individual learners. We also allow individual learners to set up individual learning paths and also the ability to host these learners on video conference and a lot more. So all of these activities to do, it demands a certain amount of resource and bandwidth from your LMS system, which is where this costing comes in. 50 to 300 based on your vendor and their LMS. Again, it is very simple. Some LMSs provide you with extra or additional features, and that is why their costing for individual learners is higher. However, not all of these features are something that your organization needs. And I repeat this because we have actually carried out researches and we have realized that before purchasing an LMS, a lot of prospective buyers are taken in by a lot of features that they see, and they're excited about using it, and they're very hyped about getting it on board. But eventually, as they start using the LMS, if you hardly three or four of these features are ever used, most of the features are never even touched, because it takes a lot of dedicated amount of time, attention, and understanding of these features to run them. So what happens is you end up paying on the higher side of 300, 180, 200, something about approximately around that 200, 250 rupees per user, which is on the higher end for features you're absolutely not using. And frankly, it is a very common story every single time. Therefore, these extraordinary over-the-top features are something that you do not need 90% of the time. And that is a fact. So in such cases, if you're going for a platform that charges you rupees 200 and above per learner, it is only advisable for you to really do an introspection where you'll check whether you all really are going to use those extra features or not, because managing those features is a whole task in itself, actually getting the output out of it. So how is the cost? How's the final cost for your active users plan basically determined? Now for this, I'll require you to look at the screen because a little bit of calculations are going to come up. Also, you'll have to remember the original example we took. Let us continue with that. Now, my organization has 500 people, and I am sure that during any given month, only 100 people will train on the LMS. Hence, I will register all 500 people, but I will buy a plan for only 100 people to use the LMS in a given month. This way, a vendor offers you plans where you can select the number of users you think will use an LMS in a given month. Now, there are slabs that charge for these varyingly. So you've got, maybe you could go for 100 active users because you're sure that only 100 will use it. You could go for 250, you could go for all 500 of your employees, or if you've got more than 500, you could go with 1000 as well. Now, in this case, you must see that the cost that is associated with each user is rupees 180, which is on the lower side. Like I said, it can vary between 150 to 300. The cost associated with us is at rupees 180, which is on the lower side, which is why if you take rupees 180, that is mentioned on the screen, that is cost per active user, and multiply it into 100 active users, which is your first plan, you end up with a costing of rupees 18,000 for 100 users in 1 month. All right, That is as simple as the calculation it is for this. So how is the really final calculation made then? Again, we'll have to look at the example over here. Rupees 180 is what I'm paying for each individual user. I have registered all 500 of my employees and I'm going on to purchase an active user plan for only 100 people, because I know that out of 500, not all 500 will use. I'm very sure that only 100 people will come on board. Hence, I bought a 100 user plan and I'm paying rupees 180 for it. Hence, the first costing, as you can see on the topmost slab, will be rupees 18,000 for 100 active users, 45,000 for 250, 90,000 for 500, and 180,000 for 1,000 active users. That is per month. So 100 active users per month, you pay 18,000. Now the lower slab is just a replication of that. Only thing is that it is for your whole year. So now if I have to look at my slab for 100 active users for a whole year, it is rupees 2,16,000 for the whole year. I can train 100 people of mine for the whole year for rupees 2,16,000, where I'm just paying 180 rupees per user, which is on the lower side, because you need to look at your LMS based on what kind of features are being offered. So what happens if you say you want to suddenly add 10 more learners because you originally had not foreseen this? What happens? It is very simple. There is a slightly higher cost associated with adding extra learners. So if you normally took the plan at rupees 180 per user, maybe your extra learners you have to purchase at rupees 200 per extra learners. In this case, if you want to add 10 extra learners, you simply pay rupees 200 for 10 extra learners, and that gets added to your plan. It is as simple as that. Nothing more than that. Now, how do you decide an active users plan? Now, there is no concrete way of saying or determining how to do this, but as a rule of thumb, we always advise our vendors to look at these two options. All right, first one is to really try and identify all the people who impact the KPI of your business. That is, they directly impact the profitability somehow. They are in charge of sales, they are client facing, they're handling manufacturing, or they're doing something else that is very important for your business. Try and identify at least these people and purchase an active user plan according to them. That is the minimum you can do. And the second one is that try to take as many as you can, take a license that can train as many of your employees as you can. But again, you have to be very wise here to not overdo it in order for you to not overpay. So you'll have to actually have a really good introspective time with your team and your management to understand how much of a user plan should you really take. All right, with that, we completed the first part of your licensing fee, the first type of licensing fee, which is active user plan. Now there is another type that is called as your registered user plan. What we spoke about was active user plan, right? Now the exact opposite of that is your registered user plan. In this case, let us take my example again. Now I have an organization where I have 500 employees. In this case, I register all 500 employees on my LMS and I pay for all 500 employees, all of them. So first plan, you register 500 and you pay for 100. Over here, I register 500 and I pay for all 500. That is called as your registered user plan. So who basically needs registered user plan? Now generally, registered user plans also charge on a per user basis. However, the prices per user under this plan is less, but y'all need to understand that that doesn't mean this plan actually costs less for organization, because the thing is, these plans are generally offered to large corporations who may have users that run in the thousands, and especially for organizations who cannot really put a cap on the number of learners that can access an LMS in a month. They cannot really afford to take a gamble on the fact that only X number of people will train in a month. They actually need to train everybody. That is why those organizations go with a plan like this. So if I have an employee base of 10,000, let us take a new example, and I really cannot compromise my training by limiting the number of people who can access my LMS, I would rather choose a registered user plan. Now, the thing is, you can almost say that this is really important for large organizations or industries where training cannot be compromised. Again, one more thing to remember over here is that what happens to extra users under this user plan? There are two ways to do it. One, you replace the new learners with old learners who are inactive or have interacted very little. Now you realize that out of your 10,000 people, 1,000 people are absolutely not using your LMS. You can replace them with new 1,000 users. No problem. Or secondly, again, just like I said, you can pay for additional accounts. It is as simple as that. So with this, we have covered the two types of licensing fees. One is your active number of users. Remember, once again, active number of users means I register all 500 employees but pay for only 100 because I am sure that only 100 will use it. And registered users, where I register all 500 users and pay for all 500 of them. And the second option is much more preferable by huge organizations where they cannot really take a gamble on the number of learners that can access their LMS in a given month. Now, before we move ahead, it's time for the second poll to come up. This will give me even more understanding before I move into the webinar. So I request your attention to the screens and just help me out with this over here. So I'd like to know what your current disposition is with regards to an LMS. So that will give me more idea on putting in more information into the next half of this webinar. So please do. It is really important to understand where along the cycle you all are right now. That way, I'm going to try and make the next half even more informative so that you all don't end up making a decision which you all may regret. Because it could get a little confusing when it comes to licensing and understanding what are the licenses and the hosting types and all that. With that, we saw the first two parts of your LMS's pricing, which you all should pay attention to. One was your setting up cost, and the second was the type of licensing fee you choose. Small organizations, it's very advisable for them to go with an active users plan. And large organizations, it's advisable to go with a registered users plan. All right. With that, we now go on to the third type, and that is your hosting. Now, what is hosting? Now, hosting is a process where your software or a code resides on a physical third-party server. Basically, most LMSs run on virtual servers, which actually helps them in becoming an SaaS based product, a SaaS service as a software as a service product. Now, in the case of you guys out there who already have LMSs, I'm very sure that even your LMS is currently being hosted on one of the two types that we're going to discuss now. It's just like your website, which is also hosted on virtual servers. Obviously, these servers are not just any random servers. They're always highly trusted and highly secure and are built specifically for the purpose of allowing organizations the freedom to run their platform over the internet so that anyone can access it. Now, this type of hosting in general allows your learners to access the LMS from anywhere in the world since it is hosted on the LMS over the internet. Now, why is cloud hosting better than installing the LMS on your organization's server? There are a certain set of reasons why it is much better that your LMS should be running on the internet and not on an internal server. And that is, so it does not take up your organization's valuable storage and computing power. It is less of a hassle for your IT staff. And thirdly, if there is ever a breakdown or some malfunction, the vendor does not have to send somebody over to your organization to fix your LMS's problems. Rather, he can fix your LMS's problems over a virtual connection itself. With that, we come down to the two types of hosting that you can select when you go in for your LMS. It's very important to remember when you go in to select your LMS. And having a discussion with this with your vendor is very important. All right. So let us break down when to choose which one and for whom is shared hosting better and for whom is dedicated hosting better. Let's break it down. Let's start with shared hosting. Shared hosting is the process where all the organizations whose LMS are the same with regards to technical specifications and other functionalities are hosted on one common server. Now say that I am a vendor, all right, and I have 5 to 6 clients who all use an LMS, all right. Now just in case if their LMS is either stock with very few integrations and customizations, they have less than 1,000 users, and it is a small semi-sized businesses, I can host all of these LMS platforms on one single server, and that is called as shared hosting, where 3 or 4 organizations can have their LMSs running on one single server. Basically, it is one single server space shared by 3 or 4 organizations. And how is it possible? It is only possible if your LMS is stock, which is it has no extra integrations and high-end customizations. And second, if it has less than 1,000 active users. So in that cases, all the similar types of LMSs can be run on one server. That is the meaning of shared hosting. So one thing to remember over here is that just because your LMS is being run on one server alongside other people's or other organizations' LMS does not mean that it is not safe, or it does not mean that you're going to face problems. The thing is, your LMSs are light and it is possible to run you all alongside other people, which is why a vendor does that, where they offer you a shared hosting plan. Also, each vendor or each LMS user will get their individual login portals. Hence, there'll be no issues of mixing it up. So there's no such thing as any issues coming because you've chosen a shared hosting plan. And there are also advantages that are associated with this. Now, this can vary from vendor to vendor, and you must be sure about what you are getting. If your organization is going with a shared hosting plan, all right, if you're going to run your LMS with a shared hosting plan, we do not levy any yearly charges. This is the biggest advantage of going with a shared hosting plan for small businesses, especially. That is, you are not charged for sharing a hosting plan, simple as that. We at Abara have always wanted small and semi-sized companies to be able to train and develop the skills of their learners, which is why we do not charge for shared hosting. But there are other vendors who might also charge you for shared hosting. So you will have to be very aware about this. All right. Hence, let us take a look at who is this best for. One, it is best for small and semi-sized businesses. Two, it is good for businesses with less than 1,000 learners. It is good for businesses looking for a simple LMS with not many customizations, mainly third-party integrations and specialized customizations. And we are going to get to this point later. And it is good for organizations with limited budgets. Also, does shared mean risky? Once again, let me tell you all, no. In our case, the web service provider who hosts your LMS on a shared platform is a huge giant, and you all might know them as Amazon Web Service Providers. For short, they are AWS. And when it comes with working with an organization like Amazon AWS, you can be sure that security is our primary concern. And security is our primary concern for another reason. We are an ISO 27001 certified organization, which makes it even more important for us. So with that, we saw the first type of hosting that is called as a shared hosting, which is free. All right, it is free. Some other vendors might charge you for it unknowingly, but technically it should always be free. With that, we come to the second type of hosting, which is called as dedicated hosting. Now, what is dedicated hosting? In short, you are not going to share an instance with any other organization in this case. Basically, a certain part of the cloud storage is dedicatedly allotted to your organization and its LMS. And your LMS is solely operating on this instance all by itself. However, whether you're going with a shared hosting or dedicated hosting, your web service provider will still remain Amazon Web Service Provider, albeit in this case, it will be independently. So why is dedicated hosting needed? In short, dedicated hosting is best suited for large organizations which have more than 1,000 learners, for organizations with a lot of third-party integrations in their LMS and multiple customizations, and for organizations who are preparing for heavy LMS usage at any given time in a month. So if your organization falls under any of the above mentioned categories, it is always best to go for a dedicated instance. Why? because a dedicated instance can take the load of a large number of learners accessing the LMS, that is 1000 learners and above. They can handle the load of multiple integrations and they are dedicatedly yours. And how does dedicated hosting add to your costs? Unlike the first option, that is your shared hosting, a dedicated hosting plan is charged. Now, what you all see on screen over here are the different slabs that we offer. So up till 250 learners, you pay rupees 97,000 for your hosting, and up to 1000 learners, you pay rupees 1,17,000, and these are yearly charges. All right. Now, big thing to remember over here, whether you're going with shared hosting or dedicated hosting. All right. These costs are actually being paid to the web service provider. The vendor does not take any cut in this. They actually have to transfer this money over to the web service provider, that is Amazon in this case, who is hosting your LMS. And why do they have to pay them? Because they have to take care of your security, make sure your LMS works smoothly, you have no problems, interferences, security breaches, all of that, which is why this cost is not come into the vendor's pocket. It always usually goes to the web service provider. However, in shared instance cases, if you're being charged right now for shared hosting, you all might have to consider that with your vendor. This is a yearly hosting cost which is being paid to the web service provider. You could also say that this is something like your internet website again, where you pay a certain amount for your internet website to be hosted on platforms like GoDaddy, BigRock, HostGator. In our case, it's Amazon web service provider. So in conclusion, if your LMS has 1000 learners, it is simple and it has no extra integrations or customizations, you can opt for a shared hosting plan which will not cost you anything on a yearly basis. On the other hand, if you're looking to accommodate more than 1000 learners and want multiple third-party integrations and customizations, a dedicated hosting plan with yearly renewal is best suited for your organization. With that, we have covered the first three parts of the LMS costing. That is your one-time setup costs. Second is your licensing fee, whether it's an active learners or a registered users. And the third is your shared hosting or dedicated hosting cost. Shared is free, dedicated is paid. All right. With that, we come down to the final part. That is your part four. And that is your additional costs. These are the additional costs that make up your LMS. Now, in most cases, these costs can be avoided. Again, it can vary from vendor to vendor, but these are additional costs and usually they are incurred only when you have a specific need in mind. So let's go over them one by one. All right, let's start with support fees. Now, a big thing, all right, it may come as a surprise, but many vendors charge for the support provided. Usually support is something that should always be free. But this is not the case in a lot of large vendors when you come to their LMSs. Now, some LMS companies charge for the phone support, while some will charge for both phone and email. So I just want you all to quickly drop me a yes or no in your chat box if you all are currently being charged for support or not. Quickly drop me a yes or no in your chat or a question option. So that will help me understand whether you guys are being charged right now or not for your support that the LMS vendor provides you with, because it's very important to know this as an SaaS based organization. All right, we pride ourselves on the fact that we have not attached any of these unconditional costs, like charging you for support or charging you for shared instance or even overcomplicating our LMS and then asking you to pay for its support. Our LMS is very straightforward. It's very simple. It's built to train with all the efficient features you need for training, and that is about it. We have not overcomplicated it for anyone here, and y'all will realize that slowly as y'all take up more of our free trials, because we give out 30-day free trials for you to take up our LMS, try it out for yourselves, play with it, add learners, add courses. You can do a range of things with it in 30 days. So I would recommend you guys to log on to our website, go on to our free LMS trial section and take our trials. They're here for you for 30 days to try. You can also visit our blog sites anytime you all want. So quickly drop me a yes or no. All right, perfect. So I got your yeses and nos. Not a problem. So let me just reiterate the fact that At Abara, we do not charge any support costs. Our costs are free. We take care of your needs as and when they come. All right, moving on, The next type of additional cost is your maintenance fee. Now, this is again something that you would certainly want to make sure your LMS provider is providing or not. Get this clear with them. What happens is your LMS provider will license your version of their LMS for a certain amount. Now, eventually, as time goes by, they may add new features to their LMS and make updates or even add something totally new to their LMS. In this case, they will come back to you and ask you to update it for a certain fee. So basically, as they add new features on their new version, you have already taken their old version. They'll ask you to actually pay for these new features in order for you to get upgraded. And they will club it under something called as maintenance fees. That is again something you should be careful about in the start. Because again, as an SaaS based organization at Abara, the moment we come out with a new feature or a new upgrade, it is automatically added to your existing LMS at your existing price. We do not charge you to just update or upgrade your LMS to any other amount. The moment a new feature comes in, we make sure that it is a part of your LMS and you get it. But a lot of vendors in the market do this, where they will give you a certain version and the next thing you know, their LMS has added 10 new features and they're charging you for an upgrade and they call it as maintenance fees. Now, that is not the deal with most SaaS based organizations. Moving on, we also have integrations which come under your additional cost. Now, when it comes to integrations, again, remember and hear me out very carefully. Most LMS providers should actually provide you with these popular third-party system integrations totally free of cost. They are actually not a cost. I have put it here, but they are actually not a cost. Why have I put it here? It's because some people will charge you. Some vendors will charge you for integrations as well. Mostly as a SaaS provider, we do not charge for these integrations and they are popular integrations. You've got your ERPs, human resource systems, your webinar handling tools, all of that. So let me just quickly give you all a brief about all the integrations Abara LMS offers. We offer single sign-on integrations, ADFS, One Login, Duo, Okta, Ping Identity. We've got Zapier integrations, Fourth Hospitality, human resource integrations, webinar tools like GoToWebinar, WebEx, Zoom, Skype for Business. All of these integrations are free of cost and a part of our LMS. We do not charge you for that once again, but other vendors might end up charging you. And then we come down to customizations. Now, along with the previously mentioned point, all right, some organizations want additional customizations. Those were integrations. Now we are talking about customizations. What are customizations? Customizations are where a totally new feature are custom built for your LMS. Totally built from scratch for LMS. So again, it is one of those things that adds to the cost of your LMS's pricing. And finally, we come down to the last additional cost, and that is user data management. Now, many of y'all here are already LMS users, right? Y'all already have employees who are training on it and they have created some kind of record for them in terms of reports, their history, their progress, courses attended, cleared, all of that. Now that is your legacy data. When y'all actually switch from an old LMS to a new LMS, y'all don't want to leave that data behind because that will actually require your learners to start from scratch once again. So there is an option to fix this. You can actually migrate your data from the old platform onto the new platform. That is called as user data management. For this purpose, the vendor usually has to do a little bit of data mining. They have to do a little bit of scripting and they have to ensure that only the relevant and needed information from your old LMS is transferred onto the new LMS, which is why this is also an added cost when it comes to setting up your LMS, but it's just a one-time cost. Most of these additional features and these additional costs are all one-time costs. So just for that purposes, user data management is something that is charged for because it is a slightly tedious process. Getting only the relevant information from old LMS to your new, you don't want to clog up your new LMS with unrequired information. With that, we have completed all four parts that constitute the final pricing of your LMS. These are only the parts that affect your pricing. There is absolutely nothing that we have not covered here. That is one, your active learners or registered learners, your shared hosting or dedicated hosting, your integrations, customizations, and your setup, and your finally your additional costs. These are the only four parts that you all need to remember as a part of your LMS's pricing. With that, we have come to the end of today's session. I know The webinar could have been a little complicated when it comes to the costing, but do not worry. Y'all can reach us out at any of these contact details and we'd be more than happy to break this down for you. Also, we'll be putting this webinar up on our website in the webinar section under resources section. So y'all can come back to it and have a look at it anytime y'all want. All right. The main agenda was to make sure that y'all are aware about the various costings that comprise of LMS. Do not overpay for something. Do not get forced into paying for something you're not supposed to pay for. Make sure you select an LMS that has the relevant features for training. Do not go for fancy, over-the-top, extraordinary features, which you may never really use. Because trust me, we have seen it more than often that people take up these LMSs and they really, the people handling them, your administrators, they really have no idea what to do with it. All right. Now, please feel free to ask me questions. We are going to try and answer as many of them. So, please shoot your questions out to us. We have also given out two handouts that are available in our handout section. There are two PDFs. One is the HR challenges and way to overcome them in 2019. Y'all should definitely give that a read. It's very interesting and it actually sheds some lights on things you'll have probably not thought about. I can challenge you on that. I'd really recommend y'all to open it and give it a read. Y'all will really find some surprising things in there. It's not like your regular article. The next one is the importance of learner analysis. This one talks about how these extra features that you all pay for are sometimes not needed. So it's the importance of learner analysis. All right. When it comes to using your LMS, do you really need all these 10,000 features and can you really process all that data? It's called the importance of learner analysis. You have these two handouts with you all right now. Download them. Open them, access them in your free times, copy the links to them. Y'all have my email ID as well. Shoot out questions to us. We are waiting for your questions. We want to interact with y'all more. Do take the time of logging onto our website, going into the blog sections. We give out a lot of information on the e-learning space, the LMS, its features and all of that. We are actually a very content-based organization who believes in explaining and bringing to attention the trends within the e-learning industry, especially because we've been in this field for 12 years and we've seen both sides of the coin. We've seen how everything works. So yes, do also take the time to log on to our website, take our free trials, try it out for yourselves, add learners, add courses, customize it, play with it. Just look at how simple it is in terms of looks. Simple doesn't mean weak. Simple simply means easy to use in our way, in our language. It is less of a hassle. It has all the features you need as an organization to train your employees and make sure they're on the right track. We have also hosted some webinars in the past, especially a really good webinar that y'all should check out on our pages. What should your training look like in 2019? It is a very in-depth webinar which talks about all the features that an LMS should really have in 2019, e-learning features, and how you should use them, how they're used. It's an in-depth webinar. Skip quickly over the slides. Take the information down for yourselves. With that, I'll be signing off for now, but I'm still taking your questions. So keep shooting them on. We are trying to answer them as fast as possible. Don't forget to take a 30-day trial. Y'all will enjoy it. Also, schedule a demo in case y'all Some people may face issues when using our LMS because they're not that fluent with using an LMS, but y'all could obviously always schedule a demo with us where one of our people come online and they help you out with how to use the LMS. They'll take you through the whole step of it. Shoot out your questions. We are here to answer. Log on to our website, take our trials, read our blogs, and have a great day. Thank you one and all for joining us. I'll be signing off here, but I'm still taking your questions. See you all for the next webinar. We'll keep you all updated. It'll obviously be a little more in depth. Have a great day.